We're here at Blessed Sacrament Parish, We Are Change LA, to meet someone who has been nicknamed the Black Pope. He's actually the Jesuit General, and his name is Very Reverend Adolfo Nicholas S.J. We're here to say hi and talk to him about his nickname and his extreme oath of the Jesuits.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Cristo ma agua.
The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Let us pray. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We are tired of words. We are tired. You just came out of a campaign, election, and the inauguration of a new president. And you know, and I partially only from the sidelines, we have been exposed to 1 year and a half of words and words and words and words. Political, or literary, or even religious words. Because also religious words have been manipulated, used with such abundance for things that were not real, that we get tired of them. The prophet comes as one who sees things with the eyes of God, because the prophets bring also the shadow side of reality. And they tell us also where things are not going to the, according to the heart of God. And they speak of the anger of God and the sadness of God. We live in a world that has become so difficult that people do not know anymore where the causes are of the pain or of the distress or of the difficulties we have. With globalization, now responsibilities are diluted. And nobody knows who is behind anything.
Oh, and then you can take your picture with him and everything.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to be... having the video check to get you two together while you're asking me why he's a Black Pope.
I should point that out, how liberal everything is. Your service. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you very much.
I had a couple of questions. I was wondering if you could clear something up for me.
Maybe later, because
just really quick. Why do they call you the Black Pope?
Oh, that's that started in the 19th century.
Did it really?
Yeah, but I don't like it because it's in terms of power, no?
Yeah.
Because they thought that the general of the Jesuits had a lot of power, but he was black, so Black Pope.
Oh, maybe. Well,
I'm not Pope, and
you don't
I have no
a
power.
And I see that there's a lot of liberal symbols here. One of the things in your Jesuit high oath, I think it is, it says something about, furthermore, you promise to declare that we'll, at the first opportunity, seek war at any opportunity against heretics, Protestants, liberals.
What is that?
See here? And that we will spare neither age nor sex nor condition, and I will hang, waste, boil, flays. You've never seen
that.
This before?
No, I've never seen it.
Strangle, bury alive.
Oh,
it's horrible. It's and I was like,
there,
look,
let me
it's...
Right
it's
here.
In the congressional record.
Thank you very much. Thank you for coming.
Can I get a picture?
As long as you don't do this.
Okay.
Okay.
Can I get a picture?
It's up to him now because
he's
got. Can I
line.
Just with you?
Sure.
Okay. Thank you so much.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Well, he was very confused. He'd never seen it before. I told him it was in the congressional record. He said that he might talk to me later about it, but there's a big line, so do we want to wait and talk to him later about it? Just so that you know what I was asking him. I furthermore promise and declare that I will, when opportunity presents, to make wage relentless war, secretly or openly, against all heretics, Protestants, and liberals, as I am directed to extirpate and exterminate them from the face of the whole earth, and that I will spare neither age, sex, or condition, and that I will hang, waste, boil, flay, strangle, and bury alive these infamous heretics, rip up the stomachs and wombs of their women, and crush their infants' heads against the walls in order to annihilate forever the exorable race. And then it goes on to say some other stuff. But you can look this up, it's on the internet. I just want to read this on camera real quick, and just trying to find a private moment. He said that I could talk to him afterward, when the line was not so busy.
You need to go outside with all that.
Okay.
Because right now he's not going to read nothing because he's going to go somewhere else.
Oh, okay. So will you have him fully scheduled? Because he said he'd talk to me afterwards. He probably doesn't know his own schedule, I imagine. Yeah.
So I need you to go outside. You can't take pictures in here, okay?
Because there's a lot of people taking pictures.
You didn't get permission to have a camera, okay?
Excuse me.
So thank you.
Do you think we were bothering you?
I think so, with your letter.
Okay.
We can't have that. Okay, thank you.
Okay, sorry. I was just trying to clear something up.
I know, but now's not the time.
It's never the time.
I read recently an article, and the title was, "I am so happy we have a financial crisis." A very strange title. And the point of the article was that we have been living a false reality. We have been living a false economy, false relationships, false projections. And now the crisis brings us down to reality and to realize that simple life is what is needed. We need simple life, but a shared life. A simple life full of compassion so that nobody around us suffers and has the difficulties that many are going through today. This is prophetic. And I don't speak about the political authority of people with power. It's not pure muscle, it's not pure energy that moves things. It's a word that can move hearts, that can move people.
Hi, Jeremy, nice to meet you. Thank you for what you said about liberation theology. I wanted to know whether you would say a word. A lot of the people around the world know that the attacks on 9/11 were an intelligence black op. And so we were wondering whether you would say a word to support a real investigation that would get to the bottom of it, because it seems to have set off a fake holy war or a religious war.
It's very difficult to know. And
no, but we know. We know that Bin Laden didn't do it, and we know that there are both Zionist networks, I'm a Jewish man, and there are also Jesuit networks that are helping cover it up. Will you say something, sir?
We thank you very much for coming.
Will you say something about?
Probably not. Thank you very much. Because
Where is the proper forum, sir? Where are the real religious people that are willing to stop the killing?
Sir,
that will stop the killing?
I know you need to go.
How many innocent people, Jews, Christians, Muslims, need to die before the religious people will tell the truth?
You need to go.
You
need to go.
Where is the proper?
You need to go.
If a religious function is not the proper place for truth, where is the proper place for truth, ma'am?
You need to go.
Where is the proper place for truth?
The time and place for it.
Where is the proper place for truth?
In a religious
community.
Can't get into that. Okay, go ahead.
Here's the thing, ma'am. We know that those attacks in 9/11 were done by intelligence networks. I'm a Jewish man. I know that there were Israeli networks involved, and we know there were.